The mother of all battles in cricket, India versus Pakistan, is going to be squaring off in a few hours from now in Dubai. Will Virat Kohli's men continue to dominate their Pakistani counterparts at the World Cup? Here is what you can expect from this marquee clash.
The World Cup, when India and Pakistan play cricket, it's World Cup Battle Royale.
India versus Pakistan, a contest that takes years to culminate now. But when it finally does, there is nothing more important than this.
Come back.
India, of course, enjoys an imperious record against Pakistan in the World Cup games, but they have earned each of those 12 victories over a period of 29 years. And to extend that record further, India will once again have to get back into their beast mode. In KL Rahul and Rohit Sharma, India have possibly one of the best opening combinations, followed by Virat Kohli, the perennial thorn in the flesh for Pakistan.
That was just an outstanding shot from an outstanding player.
Jasprit Bumrah is arguably the best in the business when it comes to bowling in the death or at any stage of the game.
It's another wicket. Was a really good knock.
His partners in crime, Mohammad Shami and Bhuvneshwar Kumar, bring with them the experience needed for such high-pressure games. And add to it the presence of Lord Shardul. Varun Chakravarti is being tipped as India's X-factor, while Ashwin, going by his performances in the warm-up games, may have finally found his mojo back. Rishabh Pant, Suryakumar Yadav, Ishan Kishan, Hardik Pandya and Ravindra Jadeja. All players of high pedigree and men who can change the course of a game at any stage. India looks the most formidable side, but the question is, what will be the 11 that will make this formidable side a World Cup winning side? India finds itself in a quandary largely because of Hardik Pandya's inability to bowl these days. That leaves India with either to play him alongside five bowlers or play a batsman short and strengthen the bowling with six bowlers. With just five bowlers, Virat will not have an option to fall back upon in case one of the bowlers had a bad day in the office. With six bowlers in the 11, the batting may look a little brittle. Hopefully, India will finally get its perfect 11, but majority of the times, India versus Pakistan games are decided on who handles the nerves better. Something Virat Kohli and his men in blue have become used to over the years. Sports Bureau, India Today.
India may have perfect record against Pakistan in the World Cup and would surely start as favourites, but their arch rivals are well capable of pulling off a surprise. They have suffered because of their unpredictability and fluctuating performances, but that's what makes them a threat too. So what could be the factors that India have to be wary of against the men in green? Here's a look.
They've come from all over the world, America, India, Middle East. Sizes, all shapes. It's just the tricolor all over.
Pakistan and unpredictability go hand in hand. Despite the weight of history against them, Pakistan wouldn't consider themselves as mere pushovers. So what could be the challenges that Pakistan may throw at the Indians? Their openers, Mohammad Rizwan and Babar Azam, have been the backbone of their batting in the recent past.
Beautifully played. Kedar Jadhav.
Rizwan is the leading run scorer in T20 internationals this calendar year, having scored 752 runs at a phenomenal average of 94. At the other end, Babar is the second on the list with over 500 runs. As a pair, they have scored 523 runs with two century and a half century stands in 10 innings, an average of 52.10. Their pace battery is another threat. They bowl fast, have decent experience under their belt, and the presence of a left-arm paceman only adds to the variety. Shaheen Shah Afridi, Harris Roff and Hasan Ali are the frontline bowlers, and they also have the option of Mohammad Wasim and Asif Ali to fall back upon. Pakistan have once again gone back to the experience of Mohammad Hafiz and Shoaib Malik, and not to forget their ability to bowl off spinners regularly. The two have earned their places in the squad with some good performances. Batting in the middle order, Hafiz has scored close to 450 runs in the last 1 year with a much acceptable average of 33. Shoaib Malik certainly forced the selectors to pick him with his recent performances in the National T20 Cup, where he got 225 runs at an impressive average of 75 and a strike rate of almost 150. Pakistan also boasts of a variety of all-rounders in their ranks, not just those who can bowl spin, but fast too. Second leading edge we've seen. Going by what was witnessed in the UAE leg of the IPL, spinners will play a crucial role in this T20 World Cup. And Pakistan have the variety to do well in the UAE. Imad Wasim, the left-arm spinner who usually bowls up front in the power play and is economical too, could once again be the trump card for them, especially with India's top three being right-handers. Leg spinner Shadab Khan has the experience of bowling on UAE wickets, and a wrist spinner is always an attacking option. Both the spinners could be crucial if Pakistan are to do well against India. But crucial could be one more man if he does get an opportunity. Fakhar Zaman, another late entrant in the T20 squad, will relish this opportunity.
The trees running down to the pitch and hitting over mid-on. That went far.
He is yet to play a T20 against India, but in the limited four opportunities he has got in ODIs, he has made his mark with 207 runs, including the century he scored to win Pakistan the 2017 Champions Trophy final. History certainly favours India, but in cricket, especially in a format like T20, one just can't lower his guard, and being the underdog could be Pakistan's biggest advantage in this game. Sports Bureau, India Today.